Hey guys, let's see how to populate a drop-down menu from an API in FlutterFlow. Let me show you the API that I'm going to use to populate the drop-down. This is my API. You can see here is a list of categories for shopping app. Let's open our project and set up our API so that we can retrieve the list of categories in FlutterFlow. Here I'm calling my PocketBase API for categories. Let's test our response. Here you can see the list of our categories with all the other objects linked to it. Let's narrow it down so we only get the title. We can do that by using query parameter. Let me add it. Add fields, type should be string and value should be title. Now let's test it again. Now we can see the response containing only title. Now we need to set up our JSON path to use in drop-down menu. In the JSON path section, go to the recommended tab. Here is our title. Let's preview it. You can see this is the list that we want to use in our drop-down list. Let's select it. Now go to the selected tab, name the JSON path and save it. Now go to the page UI. Let's add a drop-down widget to our page. Add another option to see if it's working. Let's test it. Here you can see two options to select. That means our drop-down widget is working. Now let's set it up with our API data. Select the drop-down widget. Go to the backend query. Add backend query. Select the API call. Select the API that we added. Now go to the widget properties and click on the variable icon to define options. Select the API response and in JSON path, select the JSON path. Let's save it. And now let's test it. It's worked. You successfully populated a drop-down widget with an API response. Now let's get what we selected. Add a text widget at the bottom of the drop-down. The text widget value set from variable widget state drop-down. Now let's test it again. Now we can get the user selected drop-down menu and we can use this to do filter, sorting and anything that you need to do in your app with this data. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if the video was helpful to you and if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment. I will try to answer as soon as possible. Also, please subscribe to the channel so you won't miss any updates. Keep building awesome apps.